I think emerging concepts like valve-in-valve operative techniques are absolutely important to advancing the science and the practice of medicine. However, as a practicing heart specialist, I always think of a precautionary tale and relate this back to the evidence. Do we have evidence over a long period of time that these types of approaches will in fact deliver the expectation and the promise of that type of less invasive or more minimally invasive second valve replacement operation? And the answer is we don't have that data yet. And so to a certain extent, we're relying on optimism and hope without evidence, long-term evidence. The second thing that I'm always concerned about is just a simple concept of plumbing. And so if you think about the size of the original valve that was deployed, and as that tissue valve deteriorates, necessitating another valve that could be placed using one of these more minimally invasive techniques, leading to a valve-in-valve type operation, you have to fundamentally ask the question, how much space is there left for that second valve? And if the space is not enough or the fit is tight, then what types of additional problems may arise from that? In other words, will the pressures in the heart rise more? And if they do, they can cause significant symptoms for patients. So we end up perhaps eliminating one problem and creating another.